remarks. But what's really remarkable, and frankly, Honourable Speaker, disturbing about the Premier's comments with respect to the First Nations leaders and other citizens in the community, long-standing citizens in the community, she characterized those people who did not share her worldview, which are many, I have to say. Just in the last election, close to 750,000 people disagreed with the Premier by putting an X in a ballot not for her candidates. That's a lot of people to be offending, Honourable Speaker, but in this instance, 300 people came together in the small communities in the North Coast, and the Premier characterized them as, quote, kind of a ragtag group of people. Let that sink in for a moment, would you? Kind of a ragtag group of people. Now, let me be clear about this, and let there be no ambiguity. The Premier's view of the world is that if you're not cheering her on, regardless of what's coming out of her mouth, you therefore must be some ragtag group of people. I want to ask the Premier and members on that side of the House, and particularly the member from Nechako Lakes, who has a different responsibility than other members on that side of the House, if he agrees that Grand Chief Stuart Phillip of the Union of BC Indian Chiefs is somehow ragtag, or Chief Bob Chamberlain, also from the Union of BC Indian Chiefs, is somehow ragtag. The Premier's view is that Murray Smith from Lacs-Willams, Chief Murray Smith from Lacs-Willams, he's ragtag. Councillor Stan Dennis Jr. and Chief Stan Dennis Sr., both from Lacs-Willams, also ragtag. John Risdale of the Wet'suwet'en, in the Premier's view, ragtag. Chief Yvonne Laddie of the Gitxsan, ragtag. Councillor Derek MacDonald of the Lake Babine Nation, in the minister's constituency, also, in the view of the Premier of British Columbia, is part of some ragtag group. These are people who have been on this land and on Leelu Island and in the marine environment of Port Edward, Prince Rupert, and throughout the North Coast, ragtag, because they have a point of view that's counter to the government of British Columbia.